To get a sense for the scale of the things being captured by the new James Webb Space Telescope, start by imagining you're standing outside, looking up at the night sky. It's full of stars, and ahead you can see the moon. While the moon may be the largest object in the sky, it's actually a pretty small part of it. It occupies just half a degree of your field of view, about as much as your thumbnail does, viewed at arm's length. Now let's imagine a spot 1/15th the width of the moon, the size of one of the smaller craters. You'd need about 30 million of these patches to cover the whole sky. Next, point the Webb telescope at a seemingly empty slice of space this size for about 12 hours, and what emerges is this. You can see thousands and thousands of stars, except those aren't stars. Other than a few stars in the foreground, every spot of light in the image is a galaxy. And if we could zoom in even further, we would see that each galaxy itself contains millions, billions, even a trillion stars. That is what we're seeing through the Webb Space Telescope.